system. I'm telling you, though, things have to change. At the end of this episode, one of the seven remaining nominees will graduate and thus avoid the ugly title, Canada's Worst Driver.
Episodes ago.
No.
The lousiest motorists in the entire country arrived in rehab and gave me their driver's licenses. At the end of this episode, our first graduate will get theirs back.
Thank you very much.
If you're a fan of this show, you know that every season we do a head-to-head reversing challenge that can create insane amounts of madness in the Canada's Worst Driver nominees. In fact, this course can traditionally drive our participants so batty, we call it Crazy Eights.
And Dale from St. Catharines, Ontario is up first.
My name is John, and I have nominated my Aunt Dale as Canada's Worst Driver.
John accompanied Dale to rehab.
Hit.
What do you think he hit?
But last episode, Dale said she had a falling out with John.
He doesn't want to be with me, and I don't want to be with him.
Dale wants a new nominator, so...
My name is Andrew, and I nominate my friend, Dale, as Canada's Worst Driver.
I have seen Dale do a lot of damage.
Oh.
But I haven't seen hardly all of it.
In 30 years of driving, I've probably hit about 900 cars.
There will be two moving cars on this course. Peter Mellor, our head driving instructor, is reversing the silver Honda Del Sol. And Dale is driving the red Del Sol.
Does that mean I hit something?
The goal is to reverse all the way around our figure eight without hitting anything.
You've got to be extremely cautious.
Dale is not cautious.
Yeah, I'm hitting something.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm not looking at those freaking mirrors. Why do I keep hitting things?
It's probably because you're a bad driver.
I'm not a bad driver. I'm learning very, very quickly. I'm just going to drive forward a bit.
Dale doesn't have self-awareness.
I want to be perfect.
And she's emotionally unstable.
What people don't realize is that emotional stability and self-awareness are critical.
That's behavioral psychologist Dr. Lauren Kennedy Smith. Next to her is Philippe Letourneau, our high-speed driving expert.
I've seen a lot of bad drivers on this show, but I think Dale is definitely one of the worst.
Traffic expert Cam Woolley agrees.
Even with Andrew guiding her, she's a mess.
Yeah! Peter has already made it to the halfway point where he's waiting. Dale is struggling just to get past the opening obstacles.
Like that thing you're running over now.
Okay, Dale, think. Think. Shut up and think, Dale. I'm talking to myself, not you.
Dale thinks that going faster will be better.
Yeah, wow. I'm hitting things, but wow. You know what? It's okay. You know what? It's okay.
For Dale, hitting things is a normal part of life.
The last 3 years, I've been through three cars.
In 3 years, you've been through three cars?
Yep.
Dale isn't really turning her wheel. She's just driving back and forth in the same bumper-destroying arc, oblivious to the damage she's doing.
This bumper used to be normal looking.
Okay. Oh, before I got into it?
Yeah, observation's the key to everything.
Peter has been waiting here in the middle because it's the only place on the course where there's enough room for the two cars to pass.
You hearing that?
I'm hearing it, but I don't know what it means.
It means you're striking something from where the sound is coming from.
That car.
That's the one.
My job is to rehabilitate Dale, but I'm starting to think she should never drive.
Oh, God, everybody tells me I shouldn't drive.
People do tell you that, eh?
Oh, God, all the time.
I didn't think people were telling me the truth when they told me that you are a terrible driver.
Peter is about to finish off the course.
And that should be our challenge completed.
Dale is about to finish off the car.
There's something.
You think there's something there?
I do.
Dale's driving emits a certain odor.
And there's gas.
What? Wait, do you smell gas?
Uh-huh.
I do too. Stop it. Shut it down. Shut it down. Shut it down. That's it. Let's have no sparks. When you skipped onto one of those rims, you might have hit a gas line.
A gas line?
A rim Dale ran over has indeed severed the gas line.
Something is not right with this car.
Something's not right, all right.
Slow Diane and Speed Freak Dean are next to drive this course.
I think I'm gonna smoke this, man.
At home in Montreal, Dean likes to smoke down the highway at a cool 140 kilometers an hour.
Ah, you're a bad mother driver. How can you just cross the line like that?
That's Brian, Dean's worried friend. Here in rehab, we've been trying to teach Dean to enjoy going slowly.
Damn, this is stressful, man.
But going slow makes Dean tense.
You got space, buddy.
Slow Diane is the polar opposite.
I want to go home, too.
At home in Edmonton, Alberta, Slow Diane tries to never reverse. As a result, when Diane does reverse, it takes forever.
Oh, my God. This is freaking horrible.
No.
Rayanne is one of Diane's six children. Back at the rehab center.
Oh, that was fast.
Dean is going too fast. Dean is in such a hurry, he doesn't even wait in the passing area.
Idiot, he's not even stopping. Dude!
One thing we can't tolerate in rehab.
I'm gonna push you guys.
Is bad drivers intentionally running into people.
No!
Pushing Diane means we're stopping this drive.
I have to control my temper, like when you're doing that, you know, kind of stuff.
When we come back,
what am I supposed to do?
The rest of Canada's worst drivers go through our Crazy 8 experience.
No crying, Lance.
This figure eight course is where Canada's worst drivers are showing us how safely and quickly they can reverse.
If I was doing this myself, I could probably have this done in like 2 seconds.
If you were by yourself?
No, I did not say that.
Jamie and Brad will be the next head-to-head drivers. At home in Hampton, New Brunswick.
I can't seem to park or reverse my car.
Jamie's 8-year-old son is familiar with the sound of crunching.
Oh, my God. I've torn off my front steps backing out of my driveway. I have hit this guardrail. I have hit these a few times.
Jamie's husband, Eric, is tired of all the hitting.
I always hit his truck every time I try to back out of the driveway. I hate this driveway.
At the Rehab Center Challenge course,
What do I do? What do I do?
Jamie is doing more question asking than driving.
Can I drive right now? In reverse or in drive? Am I in reverse or am I in drive?
Brad is in hell. And Brad's wife, Donna, is in a shirt that says, "Don't annoy the crazy person."
Shut up.
I'm sorry, you can't shut up. It's funny.
At home in Springbank, Alberta, Donna's laughing sometimes drives Brad crazy. Sometimes it drives him to the point of tears.
I can't deal with it, Ben. But you want to laugh?
I'm not laughing.
God.
Brad.
On our Crazy Eights course, Donna is quickly going from mocking to controlling.
There!
Donna recently suffered a severe injury to her right shoulder.
So, point towards...
Yep, got her.
That injury will prevent her from driving forever.
Crank your wheel.
I know.
Not driving is not enough control for Donna.
I know. I can get here.
Jamie would let her steer.
What am I supposed to do?
Ooh.
Jamie hates being in control of the car.
But you have to show me how to get back in there, Eric. Now! I need to go in there now!
Now Brad is finished. Except Donna wants to be the person who tells him he's finished.
You're on it. You're done. Just turn it off.
Donna's controlling nature is something she's finally acknowledging.
It's not just Brad. I mean, I'm beginning to see the bigger picture that, you know, it's me as well.
Jamie hates thinking for herself.
Now, which way am I turning? Like, what would you do? Which way am I turning? That way?
Jamie asks too many questions.
Let's go.
Go where?
Lance versus Paul will be the final drive. At home in Collingwood, Ontario, Paul does not like being in a car.
I don't like cars. I don't like vans. I want to ride my motorcycle.
When Paul is contained in a four-wheeled vehicle, he feels like he's in jail. Again.
Look at me. I'm shaking. I feel like I was back inside. I feel enclosed. I don't feel free. Feel free, man.
In rehab, Paul feels extra confined in a lot of the tiny vehicles we have.
You guys got to get normal cars for normal people.
And this Del Sol is the smallest thing we own.
We got to fit in these things, Tommy? Oh, yeah, right.
Paul's not fitting too good into that car.
Oh, yeah, no. I don't think so, guys.
Lance, on the other hand, loves the toy car.
This is the first time I've ever driven a convertible.
At home in Ottawa, Lance. Wait, that's not Lance. There he is. Lance, who works as a fashion salesman, is a new driver who really never learned how to reverse.
Was that the van or the curb?
That was the van. This is Lance's friend, Gilles, and now meet the cops.
Hi, how are you? You want me to look?
Can you check the damage? Make sure
yeah. Okay, sure.
Okay. It's time for Crazy Eights.
Hey, no crying, Lance.
Come on, man. He doesn't have to say that.
Lance has been diligently taking our daily private lessons, and the results are amazing.
Hey, you're doing good, man. I'm not even gonna say anything.
What's to say? Lance is flying around the track.
This is a piece of cake, dude.
Lance does swing his front end into some obstacles, but...
You kicked his butt, man.
Damn right I did.
Lance is at the halfway point in 48 seconds.
I can't believe you did that better than him.
In this tiny car, Paul's bad back is bothering him.
Sorry, brother.
And in his discomfort, he doesn't see this runaway rim. And that rim stops the tiny car by popping a hole in its tiny gas tank.
Good. All right, well, that's a fail, I guess, eh?
It is a fail for Paul. But a pass for Lance.
Who's the baby now?
70.
Oh, that's easy. There's no way.
When we come back, Canada's worst drivers learn to slalom.
Just put the body in the trunk and I'll take it to the river.
When we met Canada's worst drivers, we asked them to do a slalom course at 50 kilometers an hour. It was a task they all failed. So, to make sure everyone learns how to steer around stationary objects, Philippe is about to give slaloming lessons, starting with Jamie.
Let's try one.
The number one rule of driving is to look where you want to go.
Turn.
And you don't want to go into the cones.
Stop. Why do you think you hit those cones?
I was looking at them.
Therefore, you were steering towards those cones. You need to keep your eyes up and trust that you'll see the cone with your peripheral vision. Keep your eyes up. Let's go for it.
Jamie follows Philippe's advice and focuses well up the road.
Steer. And stop.
I did it.
Of course
like,
you did
I
it.
Did it. Oh, my God. Whew.
After a little time and a lot of encouragement.
You're with me.
I know. You're the best.
All of Canada's worst drivers.
I didn't knock down any.
Do learn the visual art.
Here we go. Who's in control?
I am now.
Of high-speed steering.
And I was looking ahead this time.
It's amazing.
I didn't hit anything. Oh, my God. Thank you.
It's good?
Yeah, it's good.
Here at the Driver Rehabilitation Center, we've never done a high-speed slalom because our vehicles have always been used, and we never quite trust them under stress at really high speeds. But this year, we bought a brand-new Camaro.
Our plan is to sell this new car when the series is over. It should fetch a pretty penny because it's only got 100 kilometers on the odometer.
The Camaro is about to get a lot more clicks put onto it because our high-speed slalom challenge is the longest course we've ever created. Now, this course is freaky to be sure because
drivers have to maintain 80 kilometers an hour while swerving around these foam figures.
Here I go. 70, there's 80. I maintain 80. 80, exactly. And I have to hold the wheel lightly and turn just before I get to the bend, anticipate, maintain my speed, and that's it. It's really not that hard if you know what you're doing. And thankfully, after a few years of this show, I know what I'm doing. Now let's see how Canada's worst drivers do.
Lance will be first to drive the slalom. Think he'll blow it? Lance blows the speed limit by almost going 100.
Whoa!
Lance can't simultaneously control speed and steering.
I'm learning that I have big issues.
Motorcyclist Paul doubts he can do this.
70. Oh, that's 80. There's no way.
Maneuvering like he was taught in the lesson makes Paul magical.
We got her.
Paul could become the teacher's pet.
Tell Philippe that was for him, because if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have done that.
Slow Diane is up next.
Ready?
I'm ready.
Diane is always afraid to go fast. But today, she stares dead ahead. And without realizing it, she speeds up to 90.
Oh, my God.
Diane can't focus on speed and steering.
You think I was going too fast?
Brad is up next.
Are we ready?
I am ready.
We've been asking Donna to stop screaming when Brad's driving.
80.
And today, Donna is under control. And Brad is under control.
You're staying at 80. Oh.
Oh. That is cause for celebration.
Well, that was a very good job, Brad. I'm very proud of you.
Thank you.
When we come back...
Yo! Yo!
Dean plows a farmer's field.
Man!
Canada's worst drivers are showing us how well they can drive a slalom course at 80 kilometers an hour. Before rehab, Dale liked to drive at a speed of...
About 120, 130 clicks.
What?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Why not?
Well, because it's lethal?
Lethal. Oh, yeah. Well, no. What am I saying? No. At that time, my mindset didn't think that that was lethal.
Doesn't matter what you think, it is.
Yeah, of course it is.
I don't know if I'm ready for this.
Am I ready?
People often ask me if I'm afraid when I'm in the passenger seat. And the answer is, yes, I'm usually terrified. Like right now.
Holy pass, Dale. I'm pretty amazed.
I what? I passed?
Dale looked far ahead and passed.
You do drive fast. You're just terrible going slow.
Yeah.
Jamie knows how to do this.
I'm nervous, though. Are you scared?
There's no need to be scared. Jamie was taught by a professional.
Am I at 80?
Jamie is at a turning point in her driving life.
Wow, you did it, Jamie.
I think I was doing more than... Oh, my God!
Jamie went 88K an hour and steered perfectly.
I'm very proud of myself. Very proud. This is, like, the first time since I've been here that... I'm, like, 100% happy.
Dean knows the secret of this challenge is to...
Look ahead.
Dean has a dangerous habit of lifting his foot off the pedals when things go wrong.
Where's your foot now? Brake, 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 brake.
Oh, break. I took it off.
Stop.
Let's hope he doesn't do that today.
70? 80? That's right! You got it, buddy. You got it! Yeah! What the? What the? Yo! Yo! Where the f*** are you going? Man!
I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened.
Hey, Dean. What the f*** are you doing, man?
Dean forgot to slow down.
Ah, man.
Yeah, that's f***ed up.
I don't know, man. I don't know what to say, buddy. But this time, I'm disappointed.
There are hundreds and hundreds of rules you must know to be a safe driver. How many do Canada's worst drivers know? We're about to find out. You're stuck behind a slow-moving truck on a road with two yellow lines. What do you do?
If he's... continuing to be a little slow, I would make the decision to turn on my blinker and then go around him.
You can't pass no matter what on a double line.
There are two lines because there are two lanes. The only line that matters is the one closest to you. So, if you're behind a slow driver on this road, could you pass?
I'd probably pass him.
I would realize this.
Put on my flicker. Pass him.
No, it's still a solid line on this side. I still can't pass that.
If you are in the left lane of a one-way street with two lanes, how would you turn left?
I said most morons would probably go over here. I would turn here into this lane.
Taking the inside lane is correct.
I would just take the normal outside.
If you're in the left lane, turn into the left lane.
I would go into the intersection and kind of be cautious and then turn left.
You've gone into the oncoming traffic.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. You're right.
If an oncoming school bus is stopped on the other side of the road, what do you do?
You're absolutely correct.
Yeah, I had a friend that was killed when I was going to school. She was getting off the bus, and she ran in front of the bus, and the car that was going this way didn't stop.
Always stop for a stationary school bus.
I guess they're only getting off here, right? So it wouldn't really matter. So I can just keep on driving.
Well, if there was a police officer the other side, you're going to face a $2,000 fine.
What if a police car has someone pulled over on the side of the highway? What would you do then?
What I would do is slow down my speed. I would come over here, change lanes, and keep the drive.
Lance would stop.
He'd come to a stop.
I'd come to a stop.
When a stop sign is situated 3 meters before an intersection, where should you stop?
Right there.
Many people incorrectly believe you should
stop at the stop sign.
Stop where the stop sign is.
You have to stop behind the stop sign.
In actual fact, you don't need to stop by the stop sign. If there's no white line on the road and no sidewalk, you drive the car up in line with the curb and stop at that point.
Oh.
And a lot of people don't know that.
Every stop sign has a line.
No, it doesn't.
They all have lines.
No, they don't.
Out of our 10 scenarios, Lance only got 2 right. The worst in rehab.
I don't know what to say.
When we come back, it's our annual smooth driving challenge.
What?
In China, right now, there's actually a bus company that takes smooth motoring so seriously, they hang bowls of water next to their drivers' heads. At the end of each drive, the water level is measured, and if any liquid is slopped out due to a herky-jerky commute, well, the drivers lose cash. With that revolutionary smooth driving technique in mind, it's time for our annual water tank challenge. All right. It's our annual smooth driving course. And this year's water tank challenge has 200 liters of water on the roof, and it starts with a 60 km/h straightaway.
Drivers have to get up to 60, then slow down for a turn.
It's all about starting with a slow acceleration. 40, 50, 60, I can start slowing down. Oh man, slow down. But I need to slow down slowly, or that's gonna come at me. Oh, look at it, it's just measured perfect. There it is, right on the lip. Ooh, I got away with it completely. So now I'm into a precision steering part of the course.
Remaining precise in this section will be difficult if the drivers get distracted by their cargo or if they get going too fast.
Yay, yay, yay.
From there, drivers enter a long, winding road through these rims.
Take your turns wide in a big car like this.
The rims lead drivers past a parked mobile home and towards a sadistically raised platform.
Oh, man.
I crawl onto the platform, but it's tough to stay smooth.
Slowly, slowly, young husband. Not too fast. No! Slowly, slowly, slowly.
I hate these courses. No, I'm too fast.
Ooh, I got away with it. Ooh, I thought it was...
I was too fast.
I was too fast. Yep. Great. Way to go.
Headed for the final component, my frustration is making me speed up.
Slow down, slow down, slow down!
This course ends with a slalom in reverse.
Just don't hammer on the gas, don't hammer on the brake,
and stop in front of our stop sign.
And that's it.
Time!
6 minutes!
That's not bad. Now let's see how Canada's worst drivers do.
Jamie is up first.
I'm so scared!
Hit 60, go.
Jamie accelerates way too slowly.
Hit it, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
And she stops too quickly. Ugh. Now Jamie's so confused, she's backing up.
What are you doing?
Oh, I don't know what I'm doing. Like, not, ah, get me out of here!
Jamie won't get out of rehab by trying to drive with her eyes shut.
Ah, ah. What do I do?
What Jamie does is panic. She steers through the rims. She hits the awning on the RV. And she completely botches the reverse.
I can't see where I'm going. Where is he?
Right behind you.
Total concentration is something Jamie doesn't have.
After it first came over my head, I just lost it. I just couldn't focus anymore.
Brad hits 60 late on the straightaway. And he's barely able to make the corner.
Whoa. Slow down.
Through the rims.
Oops.
Brad is going way too fast.
I don't care.
He should care. Because driving this clumsily would make most people wet themselves.
I could just pee and nobody would even know it.
Diane, for once, goes too fast.
Okay, now we're soaked.
Diane is losing focus. Through the rims.
Don't hit anything.
Diane can't concentrate.
Ram, I am trying. You don't think I want to pass this damn challenge?
Yeah, but you're going to hit. Laughing or crying? Mom! Oh, you're crying.
No.
Yes. Diane really has to stop. Crying while driving. Because it completely steals her focus. By the end, Diane's thought process has dissolved.
Oh,
did you hit it?
I hit it.
Diane's focus can get washed away.
Like I thought I was doing really good, and then just knocking over all those rims just kind of snapped.
Will motorcyclist Paul snap?
More speed, 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 and then ease off once you get to 60.
Paul makes it to 60, barely spilling a drop.
Okay, easy, easy, easy. Them around. All right, all right. A little bit of water don't hurt. You sucker.
Cars usually make Paul frustrated.
Easy, just let the thing coast.
But now, he's in control during the most frustrating circumstance.
Don't speed up.
Paul doesn't speed up, and he doesn't lose water at our pop-out car.
Oh, look at that, man.
That was smooth.
That was very smooth.
Just take your time. Let the car creep.
Paul's run isn't perfect.
Sucker.
I mean, it really isn't perfect.
Whoa. Let her eat. Easy.
But even in the occasional downpour...
Just let it creep. Just creep.
Paul never loses his cool. In the reverse section...
I'm in no rush whatsoever.
Liquids fly.
Bit of a furball there.
But the worst thing you could say about Paul's drive is that...
My hair's a mess.
Paul is cleaning up his act.
Concentration and control.
That's what they're teaching us.
Dale has accepted her original nominator back.
I'm glad because she seems to be calm with me in the car. She seems to concentrate.
I do.
You gotta get up to 60, Dale.
Dale came to rehab as a careless driver. And Dale is still a careless driver.
She doesn't seem to get the point of this challenge. If you get distracted, you still need to be in control.
Dale never cares because she won't face the truth.
My whole mentality, everything has changed. I sucked at driving.
You still do?
Yeah, a little bit, but not like I did.
Lance says...
I understand the challenge.
But when he creates a tsunami on the straightaway...
Oh, shit!
Lance completely stops caring. Lance doesn't really try.
I don't think we got that wet.
No.
No.
In fact, I'm kind of dry right now.
On Dean's run, Dean is afraid to bring the car up to speed. And as a result, he's quickly running out of room.
60. 60, Dean. 60. Put 60. 60. That's 50.
Dean flooded himself and the engine.
Oh, man. No, it's not my fault.
When we come back, someone graduates. It's time for our experts to hear from Canada's worst drivers and decide which of them should graduate, starting with Jamie.
So do you deserve to graduate this episode?
I think so, yeah.
Jamie's 80-kilometer-an-hour slalom was perfect.
I aced it.
Aced it?
I aced that.
How would you have done on that challenge when you arrived here?
Oh, I would have went right off into the field.
Yeah!
Dean did drive into the field.
Yo! Where are you going?
And I was like thinking about like to put on my brakes, but I didn't at the time because I wanted to swerve back again.
You're definitely not in control of your car.
Lance was in control while reversing.
Do you want to graduate this episode?
I want to graduate every episode. Am I going to graduate?
Slow Diane isn't going to graduate.
Oh.
Which challenge was best for you?
None.
Brad's biggest problem still seems to be the person beside him.
Okay, go up over here.
But I can't touch that area at all.
No, there!
You two are at each other, you're all over the place, and you start to get dangerous.
It feels dangerous inside. I don't want to feel this way anymore. It's too much for my body.
Have you talked to her about that?
We talked about it at home.
So you recognize that that is a huge issue that you have to address in order to
Most
drive?
Most definitely.
Paul feels as though he's addressed his biggest issue.
You deserve to graduate this episode?
Yeah, I do.
I think the greatest thing is the fact that now you're regarding the car as a friendly environment to be in.
I was in Dale's car in the reversing challenge. That was a scary environment.
Okay, don't worry about it. Don't be scared.
Okay. Maybe you shouldn't drive.
Before I came here, everybody told me that.
If you're at home laughing, think again.
I thought the show was a joke, and I thought it was funny. It's not a joke. This show is real. And it really makes you realize you could kill someone.
You could, Dale.
I am not going to kill anybody. And that's the bottom line. I'm not going to kill myself, and I'm not going to kill anybody else, and I'm not going to hit any more cars, ever.
Only Jamie, Paul, and Lance said they want to graduate. So, who will it be?
This episode, it's fairly obvious. Am I incorrect?
It's too obvious.
So we don't need to have this conversation?
Nope.
Well, that's it for the fourth episode of Canada's Worst Driver this year. Paul, when we first met Lance, we didn't think he'd be this year's first graduate. And he's not this year's first graduate.
Keep on screwing with me, man.
You are, Paul. Who else could it be, sir?
Before coming to rehab...
I'm sweating. Look at my hand. It's shaking.
Paul was as anti-car as you could get.
Cars are all bull.
But in rehab...
Ready for more training, my friend?
Yes, always.
Paul was the perfect student.
Good?
Yeah.
Like I say, you're teaching me stuff, and I appreciate that, man.
Perfect.
It's great.
Paul learned where to look.
Keep looking where you want to go.
He learned finesse.
So I'm learning every day, and I'm getting better every day.
And most importantly...
Easy.
Yeah.
Paul learned patience.
Definitely patience and control. You've got great people on the show here. I've learned a tremendous amount. I have a lot more respect than when I came.
Thanks for coming, buddy.
Thank you very much.
Here's your license back. You certainly deserve it.
All right, yeah, it's fine. Okay.
This season's first graduate.
Good thing. Good guys. All right, see ya. All right. Thank you again.
Thank you, man.
I've learned a lot.
I'm telling you, though, things have to change. At the end of this episode, one of the seven remaining nominees will graduate and thus avoid the ugly title, Canada's Worst Driver.
Episodes ago.
No, no.
The lousiest motorists in the entire country arrived in rehab and gave me their driver's licenses. At the end of this episode, our first graduate will get theirs back.
Thank you very much.
If you're a fan of this show, you know that every season we do a head-to-head reversing challenge that can create insane amounts of madness in the Canada's Worst Driver nominees. In fact, This course can traditionally drive our participants so batty, we call it Crazy Eights. And Dale, from St. Catharines, Ontario, is up first.
My name is John, and I have nominated my Aunt Dale as Canada's worst driver.
John accompanied Dale to rehab.
What do you think he hit?
But last episode, Dale said she had a falling out with John.
He doesn't want to be with me, and I don't want to be with him.
Dale wants a new nominator, so...
My name is Andrew, and I nominate my friend, Dale, as Canada's worst driver.
I have seen Dale do a lot of damage. Oh. But I haven't seen hardly all of it.
In 30 years of driving, I've probably hit about 900 cars.
There will be two moving cars on this course. Peter Mellor, our head driving instructor, is reversing the silver Honda Del Sol. And Dale is driving the red Del Sol.
Does that mean I hit something?
The goal is to reverse all the way around our figure eight without hitting anything.
You've got to be extremely cautious.
Dale is not cautious.
Yeah, I'm hitting something. Yeah. You know what? I'm not looking at those freaking mirrors. Why do I keep hitting things?
It's probably because you're a bad driver.
I'm not a bad driver. I'm learning very, very quickly. I'm just going to drive forward a bit.
Dale doesn't have self-awareness.
I want to be perfect.
And she's emotionally unstable.
What people don't realize is that emotional stability and self-awareness are critical.
That's behavioral psychologist Dr. Lauren Kennedy Smith. Next to her is Philippe Letourneau, our high-speed driving expert.
I've seen a lot of bad drivers on this show, but I think Dale is definitely one of the worst.
Traffic expert Cam Woolley agrees.
Even with Andrew guiding her, she's a mess.
Peter has already made it to the halfway point where he's waiting. Dale is struggling just to get past the opening obstacles.
Like that thing you're running over now.
Okay, Dale, think. Dale, think. Shut up and think, Dale. I'm talking to myself, not you.
Dale thinks that going faster will be better.
Yeah, wow. I'm hitting things, but wow. You know what? It's okay. You know what? It's okay.
For Dale, hitting things is a normal part of life.
The last 3 years, I've been through three cars.
In 3 years, you've been through three cars?
Yep.
Dale isn't really turning her wheel. She's just driving back and forth in the same bumper-destroying arc, oblivious to the damage she's doing.
This bumper used to be normal looking.
Okay, oh, before I got into it?
Yeah, observation's the key to everything.
Peter has been waiting here in the middle because it's the only place on the course where there's enough room for the two cars to pass.
You hearing that?
I'm hearing it, but I don't know what it means.
It means you're striking something from where the sound is coming from.
That car!
That's the one.
My job is to rehabilitate Dale, but I'm starting to think she should never drive.
Oh, God, everybody tells me I shouldn't drive.
People do tell you that, hey?
Oh, God, all the time. I didn't think people were telling me the truth when they told me that you are a terrible driver.
Peter is about to finish off the course.
And that should be our challenge completed.
Dale is about to finish off the car.
There's something.
You think there's something there?
I do.
Dale's driving emits a certain odor.
And there's gas.
What? Wait, do you smell gas?
Uh-huh.
I do too. Stop, shut it down, shut it down, shut it down. That's it, let's have no sparks. When you skipped onto one of those rims, you might have hit a gas line.
A gas line?
A rim Dale ran over has indeed severed the gas line.
Something is not right with this car.
Something's not right, all right.
Slow Diane
and speed freak Dean are next to drive this course.
I think I'm gonna smoke this, man.
At home in Montreal, Dean likes to smoke down the highway at a cool 140 kilometers an hour.
You're a bad mother driver. How can you just cross the line like that?
That's Brian, Dean's worried friend. Here in rehab, we've been trying to teach Dean to enjoy going slowly.
Damn, this is stressful, man.
But going slow makes Dean tense.
You got space, buddy.
Slow Diane is the polar opposite.
I want to go home.
At home in Edmonton, Alberta, Slow Diane tries to never reverse. As a result, when Diane does reverse, it takes forever.
Oh, my God. This is freaking horrible.
No.
Rayanne is one of Diane's six children. Back at the rehab center.
Oh, that was fast.
Dean is going too fast. Dean is in such a hurry, he doesn't even wait in the passing area.
Idiot, he's not even stopping. Dude!
One thing we can't tolerate in rehab.
I'm gonna push you guys.
Is bad drivers intentionally running into people.
No!
Pushing Diane means we're stopping this drive.
I have to control my temper, like when you're doing that, you know, kind of stuff.
When we come back...
What am I supposed to do?
The rest of Canada's worst drivers go through our Crazy 8 experience.
Nope. Crying, Lance.
This Figure 8 course is where Canada's worst drivers are showing us how safely and quickly they can reverse.
If I was doing this myself, I could probably have this done in like 2 seconds.
If you were by yourself?
No, I did not say that.
Jamie and Brad will be the next head-to-head drivers. At home in Hampton, New Brunswick.
I can't seem to park or reverse my car.
Jamie's 8-year-old son is familiar with the sound of crunching.
Oh my God. I've torn off my front steps backing out of my driveway. I have hit this guardrail. I have hit these a few times.
Jamie's husband, Eric, is tired of all the hitting.
I always hit his truck every time I try to back out of the driveway. This driveway.
At the Rehab Center Challenge course.
What do I do? What do I do?
What do I do?
What do I do?
Jamie is doing more question asking than driving.
Can I drive right now? In reverse or in drive? Am I in reverse or am I in drive?
Brad is in hell. And Brad's wife, Donna, is in a shirt that says, "Don't annoy the crazy person."
Shut up.
I'm sorry, you can't shut up. It's funny.
At home in Springbank, Alberta, Donna's laughing sometimes drives Brad crazy. Sometimes it drives him to the point of tears.
I can't deal with it, man. But you want to laugh?
I'm not laughing.
Not.
Brad.
On our Crazy Eights course, Donna is quickly going from mocking to controlling.
There!
Donna recently suffered a severe injury to her right shoulder.
So, point towards...
Yep. Got her.
That injury will prevent her from driving forever.
Crank your wheel.
I know.
Not driving is not enough control for Donna.
I know. I could get here.
Jamie would let her steer.
What am I supposed to do? Ooh.
Jamie hates being in control of the car.
But you have to show me how to get back in there, Eric. Now! I need to go in there now!
Now Brad is finished. Except Donna wants to be the person who tells him he's finished.
You're on it. You're done. Just turn it off.
Donna's controlling nature is something she's finally acknowledging.
It's not just Brad. I mean, I'm beginning to see the bigger picture that, you know, it's me as well.
Jamie hates thinking for herself.
Now, which way am I turning? Like, what would you do? Which way am I turning? That way?
Jamie asks too many questions.
Let's go.
Go where?
Lance versus Paul will be the final drive. At home in Collingwood, Ontario, Paul does not like being in a car.
I don't like cars. I don't like vans. I want to ride my motorcycle.
When Paul is contained in a four-wheeled vehicle, he feels like he's in jail. Again.
Look at me. I'm shaking. I feel like I was back inside. I feel enclosed. I don't feel free. Feel free, man.
In rehab, Paul feels extra confined in a lot of the tiny vehicles we have.
You guys got to get normal cars for normal people.
And this Del Sol is the smallest thing we own.
We got to fit in these things, Tommy? Oh, yeah, right.
Paul's not fitting too good into that car.
Oh, yeah, no. I don't think so, guys.
Lance, on the other hand, loves the toy car.
This is the first time I've ever driven a convertible.
At home in Ottawa, Lance. Wait, that's not Lance. There he is. Lance, who works as a fashion salesman, is a new driver who really never learned how to reverse.
Was that the van or the curb?
That was the van. This is Lance's friend, Gilles, and now meet the cops.
Hi, how are you? You want me to look?
Can you check the damage? Make sure.
Yeah. Okay, sure. Okay.
It's time for Crazy Eights.
Hey, no crying, Lance.
Come on, man.
He doesn't have to say that.
Lance has been diligently taking our daily private lessons, and the results are amazing.
Hey, you're doing good, man. I'm not even going to say anything.
What's to say? Lance is flying around the track.
This is a piece of cake, dude.
Lance does swing his front end into some obstacles, but...
You kicked his butt, man.
Damn right I did.
Lance is at the halfway point in 48 seconds.
I can't believe you did that better than him.
In this tiny car, Paul's bad back is bothering him.
Sorry, brother.
And in his discomfort, he doesn't see this runaway rim. And that rim stops the tiny car by popping a hole in its tiny gas tank.
Good. All right, well, that's a fail, I guess, eh?
It is a fail for Paul. But a pass for Lance.
Who's the baby now?
70. Oh, that's 80. There's no way.
When we come back, Canada's worst drivers learn to slalom.
Just put the body in the trunk and I'll take it to the river.
When we met Canada's worst drivers, we asked them to do a slalom course at 50 kilometers an hour. It was a task they all failed. So, to make sure everyone learns how to steer around stationary objects, Philippe is about to give slaloming lessons, starting with Jamie.
Let's try one.
The number one rule of driving is to look where you want to go.
Turn.
And you don't want to go into the cones.
Stop. Why do you think you hit those cones?
I was looking at them.
Therefore, you were steering towards those cones. You need to keep your eyes up and trust that you'll see the cone with your peripheral vision. Keep your eyes up. Let's go for it.
Jamie follows Philippe's advice and focuses well up the road.
Steer, 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 steer. And stop.
I did it.
Of course
like,
you did
I
it.
did it. Oh, my God. Whew.
After a little time and a lot of encouragement...
You're with me.
I know. You're the best.
All of Canada's worst drivers...
I didn't knock down any.
...do learn the visual art...
Here we go. Who's in control?
I am now.
...of high-speed steering.
And I was looking ahead this time.
It's amazing. It's amazing.
I didn't hit anything. Oh, my God. Thank you. Thank you.
It's good?
Yeah, it's good.
Here at the Driver Rehabilitation Center, we've never done a high-speed slalom because our vehicles have always been used, and we never quite trust them under stress at really high speeds. But this year, we bought a brand-new Camaro.
Our plan is to sell this new car when the series is over. It should fetch a pretty penny because it's only got 100...
I think we lost him. I'm telling you, though, things have to change. At the end of this episode, one of the 7 remaining nominees will graduate and thus avoid the ugly title Canada's Worst Driver. Episodes ago.
No, no.
The lousiest motorists in the entire country arrived in rehab and gave me their driver's licenses. At the end of this episode, our first graduate will get theirs back.
Thank you very much.
If you're a fan of this show, you know that every season we do a head-to-head reversing challenge that can create insane amounts of madness in the Canada's Worst Driver nominees. In fact, this course can traditionally drive our participants so batty, we call it... Crazy Eights!
And Dale, from St. Catharines, Ontario, is up first.
My name is John, and I have nominated my Aunt Dale as Canada's Worst Driver.
John accompanied Dale to rehab.
What do you think he hit?
But last episode, Dale said she had a falling out with John.
He doesn't want to be with me, and I don't want to be with him.
Dale wants a new nominator, so...
My name is Andrew, and I nominate my friend, Dale, as Canada's Worst Driver.
I have seen Dale do a lot of damage.
Oh.
But I haven't seen hardly all of it.
In 30 years of driving, I've probably hit about 900 cars.
There will be 2 moving cars on this course. Peter Mellor, our head driving instructor, is reversing the silver Honda Del Sol. And Dale is driving the red Del Sol.
Does that mean I hit something?
The goal is to reverse all the way around our figure eight without hitting anything.
You've got to be extremely cautious.
Dale is not cautious.
Yeah, I'm hitting something. Yeah. You know what? I'm not looking at those freaking mirrors. Why do I keep hitting things?
It's probably because you're a bad driver.
I'm not a bad driver. I'm learning very, very quickly. I'm just going to drive forward a bit.
Dale doesn't have self-awareness.
I want to be perfect.
And she's emotionally unstable.
What people don't realize is that emotional stability and self-awareness are critical.
That's behavioral psychologist Dr. Lauren Kennedy Smith. Next to her is Philippe Letourneau, our high-speed driving expert.
I've seen a lot of bad drivers on this show, but I think Dale is definitely one of the worst.
Traffic expert Cam Woolley agrees.
Even with Andrew guiding her, she's a mess.
Yeah. Peter has already made it to the halfway point where he's waiting. Dale is struggling just to get past the opening obstacles.
Like that thing you're running over now.
Okay, Dale, think. Dale, think. Shut up and think, Dale. I'm talking to myself, not you.
Dale thinks that going faster will be better.
Yeah, wow. I'm hitting things, but wow. You know what? It's okay. You know what? It's okay.
For Dale, hitting things is a normal part of life.
The last 3 years, I've been through 3 cars.
In 3 years, you've been through 3 cars?
Yep.
Dale isn't really turning her wheel. She's just driving back and forth in the same bumper-destroying arc, oblivious to the damage she's doing.
This bumper used to be normal-looking.
Okay. Oh, before I got into it?
Yeah. Observation's the key to everything.
Peter has been waiting here in the middle because it's the only place on the course where there's enough room for the 2 cars to pass.
You hearing that?
I'm hearing it, but I don't know what it means.
It means you're striking something from where the sound is coming from.
That car.
That's the one.
My job is to rehabilitate Dale, but I'm starting to think she should never drive.
Oh, God, everybody tells me I shouldn't drive.
People do tell you that, hey?
Oh, God, all the time. I didn't think people were telling me the truth when they told me that you are a terrible driver.
Peter is about to finish off the course.
And that should be our challenge completed.
Dale is about to finish off the car.
There's something.
You think there's something there?
I do.
Dale's driving emits a certain odor.
And there's gas.
What? Wait, do you smell gas?
Uh-huh.
I do too. Stop it. Shut it down. That's it. Let's have no sparks. When you skipped onto one of those rims, you might have hit a gas line.
A gas line?
A rim Dale ran over has indeed severed the gas line.
Something is not right with this car.
Something's not right, all right.
Slow Diane and Speed Freak Dean are next to drive this course.
I think I'm gonna smoke this, man.
At home in Montreal, Dean likes to smoke down the highway at a cool 140 kilometers an hour.
Ah, you're a bad mother driver. How can you just cross the line like that?
That's Brian, Dean's worried friend. Here in rehab, we've been trying to teach Dean to enjoy going slowly.
Damn, this is stressful, man.
But going slow makes Dean tense.
You got space, buddy.
Slow Diane is the polar opposite.
I want to go home, so.
At home in Edmonton, Alberta, Slow Diane tries to never reverse. As a result, when Diane does reverse, it takes forever.
Oh, my God. This is freaking horrible.
No.
Rayanne is one of Diane's 6 children. Back at the rehab center.
Oh, that was fast.
Dean is going too fast. Dean is in such a hurry, he doesn't even wait in the passing area.
Idiot, he's not even stopping. Dude!
One thing we can't tolerate in rehab.
I'm gonna push you guys.
Is bad drivers intentionally running into people.
No!
Pushing Diane means we're stopping this drive.
I have to control my temper, like when you're doing that, you know, kind of stuff.
When we come back,
what am I supposed to do?
The rest of Canada's worst drivers go through our Crazy 8 experience.
Nope. Crying, Lance.
This figure 8 course is where Canada's worst drivers are showing us how safely and quickly they can reverse.
If I was doing this myself, I could probably have this done in like 2 seconds.
If you were by yourself?
No, I did not say that.
Jamie and Brad will be the next head-to-head drivers. At home in Hampton, New Brunswick.
I can't seem to park or reverse my car.
Jamie's 8-year-old son is familiar with the sound of crunching.
Oh my God.
I've torn off my front steps backing out of my driveway. I have hit this guardrail. I have hit these a few times.
Jamie's husband, Eric, is tired of all the hitting.
I always hit his truck every time I try to back out of the driveway. This driveway.
At the Rehab Center Challenge Course.
What do I do? What do I do?
What do I do?
What do I do?
Jamie is doing more question asking than driving.
Can I drive right now? In reverse or in drive? Am I in reverse or am I in drive?
Brad is in hell. And Brad's wife, Donna, is in a shirt that says, "Don't annoy the crazy person."
Shut up. I'm sorry, you can't shut up. It's funny.
At home in Springbank, Alberta, Donna's laughing sometimes drives Brad crazy. Sometimes it drives him to the point of tears.
I can't deal with it, Ben. But you want to laugh?
I'm not laughing.
Not.
Brad.
On our Crazy Eights course, Donna is quickly going from mocking to controlling.
There!
Donna recently suffered a severe injury to her right shoulder.
So, point towards...
Yep. Got her.
That injury will prevent her from driving forever.
Crank your wheel.
I know.
Not driving is not enough control for Donna.
I know. I can get here.
Jamie would let her steer.
What am I supposed to do? Ooh.
Jamie hates being in control of the car.
But you have to show me how to get back in there, Eric. Now! I need to go in there now!
Now Brad is finished. Except Donna wants to be the person who tells him he's finished.
You're on it. You're done. Just turn it off.
Donna's controlling nature is something she's finally acknowledging.
It's not just Brad. I mean, I'm beginning to see the bigger picture that, you know, it's me as well.
Jamie hates thinking for herself.
Now, which way am I turning? Like, what would you do? Which way am I turning? That way?
Jamie asks too many questions.
Let's go.
Go where?
Lance versus Paul will be the final drive. At home in Collingwood, Ontario, Paul does not like being in a car.
I don't like cars. I don't like vans. I want to ride my motorcycle.
When Paul is contained in a four-wheeled vehicle, he feels like he's in jail. Again.
Look at me. I'm shaking. I feel like I was back inside. I feel enclosed. I don't feel free. Feel free, man.
In rehab, Paul feels extra confined in a lot of the tiny vehicles we have.
You guys got to get normal cars for normal people.
And this Del Sol is the smallest thing we own.
We got to fit in these things, Tommy? Oh, yeah, right.
Paul's not fitting too good into that car.
Oh, yeah, no. I don't think so, guys.
Lance, on the other hand, loves the toy car.
This is the first time I've ever driven a convertible.
At home in Ottawa, Lance. Wait, that's not Lance. There he is. Lance, who works as a fashion salesman, is a new driver who really never learned how to reverse.
Was that the van or the curb?
That was the van. This is Lance's friend, Gilles, and now meet the cops.
Hi, how are you? You want me to look?
Check the damage, make sure
yeah. Okay, sure.
Okay. It's time for Crazy Eights.
Hey, no crying, Lance.
Come on, man. He doesn't have to say that.
Lance has been diligently taking our daily private lessons, and the results are amazing.
Hey, you're doing good, man. I'm not even gonna say anything.
What's to say? Lance is flying around the track.
This is a piece of cake, dude.
Lance does swing his front end into some obstacles, but...
You kicked his butt, man.
Damn right I did.
Lance is at the halfway point in 48 seconds.
I can't believe you did that better than him.
In this tiny car, Paul's bad back is bothering him.
Sorry, brother.
And in his discomfort, he doesn't see this runaway rim. And that rim stops the tiny car by popping a hole in its tiny gas tank.
Good. All right, well, that's a fail, I guess, eh?
It is a fail for Paul. But a pass for Lance.
Who's the baby now?
70. Oh, that's 80. There's no way.
When we come back, Canada's worst drivers learn to slalom.
Just put the body in the trunk and I'll take it to the river.
When we met Canada's worst drivers, we asked them to do a slalom course at 50 kilometers an hour. It was a task they all failed. So, to make sure everyone learns how to steer around stationary objects, Philippe is about to give slaloming lessons, starting with Jamie.
Let's try one.
The number one rule of driving is to look where you want to go.
Turn.
And you don't want to go into the cones.
Stop. Why do you think you hit those cones?
I was looking at them.
Therefore, you were steering towards those cones. You need to keep your eyes up and trust that you'll see the cone with your peripheral vision.
Keep your eyes up. Let's go for it.
Jamie follows Philippe's advice and focuses well up the road.
Steer, 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 steer. And stop.
I did it.
Of course
like,
you did
I
it.
Did it. Oh, my God.
After a little time and a lot of encouragement,
you're with me.
I know, you're the best.
All of Canada's worst drivers,
I did not turn any,
do learn the visual art.
Here we go. Who's in control?
I am now.
Of high speed steering.
And I was looking ahead this time.
It's amazing. It's amazing.
I didn't hit anything. Oh my God. Thank you. Thank you.
It's good?
Yeah, it's good.
Here at the Driver Rehabilitation Center, we've never done a high-speed slalom because our vehicles have always been used and we never quite trust them under stress at really high speeds. But this year, we bought a brand new Camaro.
Our plan is to sell this new car when the series is over. It should fetch a pretty penny, because it's only got 100 kilometers on the odometer.
The Camaro is about to get a lot more clicks put onto it, because our high-speed slalom challenge is the longest course we've ever created.
Now, this course is freaky to be sure because
drivers have to maintain 80 kilometers an hour while swerving around these foam figures.
Here I go. 70, there's 80. I maintain 80. 80, exactly. And I have to hold the wheel lightly and turn just before I get to the bend, anticipate, maintain my speed, and that's it. It's really not that hard if you know what you're doing. And thankfully, after a few years of